Everybody's watching her, but she's looking at you.
Not subscribe, make sure you go ahead and hit that button so you will never miss another upload from me. This is another segment of Makeover Monday. Right now I am just concealing her eyelids just to cancel out any of her natural color on her lids, and this is just going to give me a blank canvas to work with. After that, I'm going to set it with my Laura Mercier translucent powder, and I'm also going to apply tape to the edges of her eyes, and that's just going to give me that crisp look at the edge. And the first eyeshadow that I'm going in with is Burnt Orange, and this is out of my Anastasia Beverly Hills palette. I really love this eyeshadow as a transition color. As you can see, I'm just blending it out and building it up. And next I'm going to go in with Regard, and this is another shade out of the same palette, and I'm just blending this more into my crease area and trying to blend it into the color Burnt Orange. This is just a deeper orange shade, and I'm using a Sedona Lace brush to blend this out. As you can see, I'm building this color up. Next, I'm going to go back in with my transition brush just to blend out any harsh lines and blend the two eyeshadows together. Next, I'm going to go in with Cypress Umber, and this is sort of a brown shade, and I'm just blending this directly into the crease area and slightly above, and I'm just using a crown brush to do this. After blending out Cypress Umber, I'm going to take the color Licorice out of my Semi-Sweet Chocolate Bar palette, and I'm going to blend it into this area right here. I'm gradually building this color up. You don't want to take too much black eyeshadow at one time because it is hard to blend out if you take too much at one time. So I'm taking a little bit by little bit and blending it to my desired color. Next, I'm taking the shade Warm Honey from the LA Girl Pro Concealer Collection, and this is the concealer that I'm using to cut my crease. I'm not doing a full cut crease, this is just like a half cut crease, and this is just going to give me like a blank spot on the eyelid to apply a lid shade. And I went in with another yellow before this one and I didn't like it, so I took this yellow that I just showed you and I'm applying it everywhere I applied concealer, and I'm just building this shade up. After that, I'm going to take the same brush that I had Licorice on and just blend out any harsh line and blend that yellow and that black together. The Glenna primer that I'm using is by e.l.f. I believe this retails for $4, which is extremely affordable. You cannot beat that with a stick, honey. And the glitter that I'm using is from eBay. And so many of you all have asked about this glitter, and I will leave a link down below in the description box so you can check it out. But I'm just packing this glitter all onto my lid. After I pack this glitter onto my lid, I'm going to move on to my face. You see, I'm removing the tape, and the LA Girl Pro Concealer that I'm using to correct the dark spots is the shade Orange. I know this is the part you all have been waiting for, how to cover up those acne spots and those dark spots. So I'm just placing this concealer everywhere she has a dark spot, and you usually use a green concealer to cover up the red spots, but I am putting an orange concealer over top of it. I just feel like it's gonna work best, and you just use what's best for your skin. If you have red spots, try using a green corrector to cancel out the redness, but you can also try an orange corrector, and sometimes it works. I know for her redness, it works. But I'm just blending it out with a little disposable foundation wedge, and I'm just blending it into the skin. Take your time blending this out. Next, I'm going to take my foundation. I am placing Truly Topaz on her skin, and this is by Black Radiance, and it's a little too light, so I'm going to mix it with Beautiful Bronze, and this is a concealer from LA Girl. It comes down to it, there are basically no rules to makeup. You use what you have. That's why I mixed a darker concealer in with her foundation just to make sure it matched her skin complexion. And you may have to do this for the summertime because you may have gotten a tan and the foundation that you use for the winter time may not match your skin right now. So just mix in a darker shade of concealer or another darker foundation to get your right skin complexion color. Did that make sense? Yeah, I hope so. But now I'm just going to conceal and highlight her face, and I'm using the shade Warm Honey from LA Girl, and I am just going to apply this under her eyes, down the bridge of her nose, her forehead, and her cupid's bow and her chin. I'm blending this out with a damp beauty blender. You want to make sure your beauty blender is damp. Blending out the concealer, I'm going to go back in with my foundation brush and blend out the harsh edges, and I'm going to set her face, her all of her concealer with the Laura Mercier powder, and it should look like this. And I'm just going to let that bake on her skin. Next, I'm going in with this bronzer from the CoverGirl Queen collection. This is the shade 120, and I'm using this to bronze up her face, and I'm using it to basically contour. This is basically going to add some more structure back into her face, because after applying foundation, it can definitely wash out any structure that you may have in your face. And I'm just brushing away the translucent powder. I'm using a pressed foundation. This is from L'Oreal, and this is just going to help remove the powder. The blush that I'm using is Berry Shimmer, and this is from Wet n Wild. And the highlighter that I'm using is my absolute favorite highlighter, and this is Champagne Pop. I could have used a more goldier highlight on her, but I went with Champagne Pop since that was already in my hand. Next, I'm going to contour her nose. I'm using the same bronzer that I used to bronze up her face. And now I'm just highlighting the tip of her nose and everywhere I want to make stand out all the high points of her face. Now I'm placing eyeshadow under her waterline, and the shade that I'm using is Cypress Umber. And next I'm going to apply some mascara under there just to make those lower lashes pop. The liner that I'm using to line her lips is Max Cork. And next I'm going to go in with I do not know the exact shade, but this is a liquid suede from NYX. The exact name will be down below in the description box, so make sure you check it out. I just did a light line with the lip pencil, nothing too dramatic. And I just wanted to leave the lips nude because I didn't want too much of a dramatic look, because the eyes are dramatic by themselves. But this basically completes the look. I hope you guys have enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, make sure you give me a big old thumbs up. Also, subscribe to my channel if you are not yet subscribed, so you will never miss another upload. Also, follow me on my social networks. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Let me know down below any other looks that you guys want to see, any other models that you want me to use, what complexion you want them to be, what you want me to do, what kind of skin type you want them to have. But I will see you guys in my next video. Thank you so much.